बेसिकली टुडे सेशन वुड बी फोकस ऑन टू इम्पॉर्टेंट आस्पेक्ट दैट इज हाउ वी कैन क्रिएट एन असाइनमेंट फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स फॉर द असेसमेंट एंड ऑल्सो हाउ वी कैन इवेल्युएट यूजिंग अ रूब्रिक बेस्ड फीचर्स अवेलेबल थ्रू वेरियस लर्निंग मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम. देर इज सो मेनी लर्निंग मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम एंड वर्चुअल लर्निंग एनवायरमेंट आर अवेलेबल. बट इफ यू सी द करेंट सीनेरियोज ऑफ वर्चुअल लर्निंग एनवायरमेंट और लर्निंग मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम इवन द गूगल क्लासरूम विच इज नथिंग बट दे हैव अडॉप्टेड मैकेनिज्म, दे आर फॉलोइंग द पेडागॉजी ऑफ लर्निंग मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम. इट इज अमर्ज एज ए वेरी गुड सोल्यूशन, वेरी प्रॉमिसिंग सोल्यूशंस फॉर टीचिंग लर्निंग प्रोसेस. इट ऑल्सो ऑफर्स लॉट्स ऑफ फीचर विच वॉज ट्रेडिशनली देयर विथ मेनी ऑफ द लर्निंग मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम लाइक मॉडल. So we will be covering the two important aspects. The first is creation is the rubric based assignment, creation of rubric based assignment and evaluation. And second aspect I'll be covering the Google assignment, which is a new feature introduced in Google. It's a very good feature, and the people who are even not interested to hold their courses through Google Classroom, they can use this feature and it can be easily integrated with any of the learning management system like Moodle. So it's very good feature. It's a new feature in Google, and fortunately I was associated with that process, and it is a wonderful feature introduced recently. So I'll covering both the aspects. So before going into detail, let us understand the idea of rubric. Okay, so rubric is nothing but a set of criteria and performance indicators. It is nothing but the criteria for each and every assignment. Here you need to fix the criteria, just like you have. Suppose that you are evaluating a PowerPoint presentation. So what should be the criteria? Student skills skills maybe are the criteria. That is the presentations, conceptualization of the idea, their body language. These can be a criteria. Okay. So if rubric is nothing but we are evaluating the assignment. We are creating a rubric assignment which follows the which contains the criteria. Means one assignment is evaluated by so many parameters so that we can make a reliable judgment. Okay, so the benefit of rubric is that if it is well-defined rubric, just like in for PowerPoint presentations, we are evaluating student PowerPoint presentations based on their performance in the class. If they are presenting in the class, how we can evaluate? Just like we can evaluate the conceptualization of the ideas, their body language, even their coordinations, as well as the content. So these, if we can define this set of criteria properly and systematically, what will happen? A student will have a consistent grading across the same questions, and there is a possibility that the same assignment can be evaluated by multiple teachers based on the number of questions selected and they even the portion selected. Just like PhDs admissions, what we are doing here that we have a mechanism that student have to write a proposal. They have to present a proposals. Okay, so what we can do that we can the same proposal can be evaluated by so many teachers, and just like methodology section I will cover, the review of literature section will be covered by another teacher, the discussion and the research design part will be taken by another teacher. So each and every criteria will be checked by so many teachers. So student will get the consistent grading across, and it will bring a transparency. So if you see the element of rubric, it is very simple to create rubric based assignment. Okay, so what are the criteria it has? There are three elements of any rubrics. Okay, first is the criteria. As I said, that for presentation you can have content, subject knowledge, conceptualization of the ideas, etc. Okay, even the second part is very important, that is level of performance. Just like you can evaluate the same criteria based on various parameters in terms of Likert scale. Okay, just like in Likert scale you can have excellent, good, average and poor. So this may be the level of performance. And the final thing is the descriptor. Each level of performance should be indicated by a descriptor. Means if we are assigning a good level of performance to a student, what is the explanation? So rubric helps you can create a set of descriptors so that a student can know that in which part they have performed well and which part of their assignments are having a lacuna. So there is steps to develop a rubric. Just a second. So there is steps in developing a rubric. These steps helps to develop a very good rubric feature. That the first important thing in the rubric is that we have to clearly define the assignment. It means that the same rubric can't be applicable for all kind of resources. Just like if you are evaluating a PowerPoint presentation, you need a different kind of rubric. Suppose that you are evaluating a research thesis, you need a different kind of rubric. Even if you are evaluating a research paper of a student, you need a different rubric. So each and every kind of assignment, each and every type of assignment, you need a different kind of rubric. So make sure that your rubric is directly associated with the kind of assignment, a type of material you are going to evaluate. Once you have defined the type of assignment, then you must have to consider what student learning outcome. Okay, so just like it is also many parameters, just like it is correct, it is incorrect, or partially correct, or it is not correct. Okay, so based on that, learning outcome must be clearly defined. I can define. Now you have to define the criteria. Criteria is very much important. You can, for each and every type of assignment, you have to define different set of criteria, because each and every type of assignments are not same and they can't be evaluated on the same parameters. Once you have defined the criteria, you must have to write the descriptors. Just like if you are writing good, you are giving good level of performance to a student, it means that you have to clearly define what good means. Okay, here I have given a very brief example that what is the difference between scales and rubrics. There are certain parameters already there, This is an analytical kind of rubric I'm telling you about, but there is another way to define a rubric. But rubric is somewhat different in the context of scales. So in scale, generally we are evaluating any performance, or you are judging any parameters based on certain parameters. Just like if something is present, then it is yes, tick mark. If it is something is missing, then it is a cross mark. But rubric is much more. If same thing can be evaluated on rubric, we have to write the criteria, just like I have written the criteria, citation as a criteria. And then I have said the level of performance that is below expectation. Citation is below expectation, meet expectation, and exceed expectations. And the four most important, that writing the descriptor, which is very much important. Descriptor, if I am marking a student as a below expectations, then I have to write the description. This is nothing but descriptor, which is not possible through scale. Scales only determine something is present or something is missing. It is a check mark or it is crossed. But here you have to clearly define the criteria, set of indicators. Okay, you have to define this criteria, you have to define the set of indicators like level of performance and the descriptor. Descriptor is very important. Just like in, if I have marked at a below expectation, it means that I have to write that if it I am marking as a below expectation, I have written as the paper fails to cite sources using a consistent formal citation style. So if I mark so that a student can understand that they got below expectation grade, and this is the nothing but a comment, okay, descriptor, and they have failed to cite the consistent formal and citation style, that's why they got below expectation. If I marked a student as a exceed expectation as per the criteria of citation, I could write that all citation are complete, okay, accurate, and consistently conform to a formal style. So this is the way we could create the rubric, and for each and every criterias must be evaluated on certain level of performance. You can choose any of the performance. Rubric can be based on the marking type, when you can assign the marking, means from either for each and every level of performance you can give mark, or it can be evaluated directly based on the criteria. So it is entirely depends on you. You can create rubric based on either the marking scheme, either through the criteria basis. I'll tell you in detail while demonstrations. So this is a brief I have covered so far about the rubric-based criteria. If you see, the rubric is somewhat different for each and every kind of assignment. If you see even across Google, if you go through the various learning management system or virtual learning environment, you will see that each and every learning management system supports this rubric features. Okay, rubric is something very common, but it is a very less used feature in learning management system. So for people are even not aware about how to use rubric, and if this can be used consistently across for evaluating assignment, it will bring a transparency, as well as student will get a very good consistent grade. So you see here, I'm showing this. This is the rubric based template I have downloaded so far. I have modified little bit. Rubrics are, it is in all these learning management platform, you will see that they have already given rubric templates. So based on the performance, based on the criteria they have adopted, you can download those rubric and reuse for different purpose. Even once you will reuse, even if you are using through Google Classroom, you can reuse several times and many times as and when it is needed. Okay, so just like I'm evaluating parameter, this is the rubric for presentation evaluations. What we have done, first we have to create the criteria. I have created a criteria like organization, content, subject knowledge, style, and then overall rating. Overall will come automatically, and there is subject knowledge and there is also communication and time management. Okay, so here I have said the criteria. Okay, now I have said the level of performance on the basis of office, or on the basis of a criteria can be evaluated. So I said in the beginning that it can be marking based criteria, or it can be the criteria based, level of performance based. So either the organization of the organization part can be evaluated on proficient, acceptable, need improvement, or unacceptable, or it can be evaluated based on the excellent. 4 for excellent, 3 for good, 1 for fair, and 0 for poor. So it is based on you. Okay. So you are going to evaluate based on excellent, good, fair, or poor, or you are going to evaluate with non-marking level of performance, that is proficient, acceptable, need improvement, and unacceptable. At the content level also, and here is the descriptor. Okay, here is the descriptor. I have written so for many descriptors. Okay, suppose that for the presentations I have written, if student will get excellent or a proficient, I have written that student shows into and present information in logical, interesting sequence which engage the audience. Okay, if it is unacceptable, then I have written that descriptor as delivery not smooth and audience attention lost because there is no sequence of information. That's why I have assigned a zero mark, and it is unacceptable based on the parameters or level of performance. Okay, the same way I have defined the content, I have defined the subject knowledge, and I have written the descriptor. So writing criteria is not very criteria is important, but for most important is writing the descriptor. Descriptor reflects your comment about certain level of performance on the basis of certain skills. On the basis of that, assignment can be evaluated. Even a student can better know that in which part. Just like if a student can get a very excellent grade in organization level, but at the content level he can get need improvement. So he or she can know that in which part they are lacking and which part they are performing well. So this is the way things work with the rubric. Even there is lot of templates are available, just like I'll share to you so that you can use it. Oh, sorry. This is for essay. So I have this is conclusion, structure, idea, evidence. Also for research paper can be also evaluated based on the rubric. So criteria I have designed. Even I have taken from so many templates. I have not designed my own. Okay, so here what I did, I have modified based on my requirement. Okay, so just like research paper, what I did, I have made the criteria introduction, focus and sequencing, support services and conclusion, and citation style and communication, and citation and references. Okay, same way it can be evaluated like excellent, good, acceptable, or unacceptable, or it can be evaluated based on the parameter exceed standards, occasionally exceed, meet standards, or below standards. So these can be evaluated. So either you can go for the marking wise, or you can set a criteria level by level of performance. Here the descriptor is very important. You must have to write the clear descriptor. And it is a practice. Once you define the rubric, you can reuse several times as and when it is needed. So it is based on your requirement. It is based on totally your performance, your perception about students and how they can be evaluated based on certain parameters. Even I have a lot of templates for reports. I have for critical thinking, even lots of even rubrics are available over the net. You can search, Google it, and you can have the rubrics as per your requirement. You can modify as per the requirement and use it for different purpose. Okay. So now I'm going to demonstrate this rubric based on the Google Classroom. This is the rubric which I have taken for hypothesis, method, results, and discussion for research reports of students. I have made a criteria like proficient, if it is a non-marking criteria, proficient, good, acceptable, and unacceptable, and a marking criteria as excellent, good, fair, and poor. So just like I've said the hypothesis, methods, results, discussion, and organization and writing, these are the criteria I have set for evaluating a student project report, like a BTP project report. Okay. So here I have written the descriptor that if in the case of hypothesis, I'm evaluating the hypothesis. So I could write like hypotheses are clearly stated with a specific directional prediction. For good, I have written that hypotheses are stated with a specific directional prediction, but unclear. And unacceptable, I have written that make some predictions, but non-directional or non-clear. And if it is unacceptable, I have written there no prediction about the result. Okay. And I can evaluate based on the proficient, good, acceptable, or unacceptable, or the marking based level of performance like excellent, good, fair, and poor. So this is the way we can design rubric. It is very simple to design, and it's a one-time investment. Once you design, you can reuse for several times. Okay. Now I am going to demonstrate this feature with the Google Classroom. This is the classroom page I have created so far for your workshop, your FDPs. Okay. So for whenever it is a common practice, you should take into account that whenever you create any Google Classroom page, the organization content in the form of this. First would be the e-discussion. It will follow the four quadrant approach. E-discussion followed by the e-content, then e-tutorial. Even e-tutorial can be upper. Okay. So your organization of the content would be as follows. First, you must have to follow the four quadrant. It is recommended practice, and it is the e-learning pedagogy adopted by many of the learning management system, including Moodle. So what you need to do, that you have to follow the four quadrant, that is e-discussion at the top, then e-tutorial, video tutorial at the just below that, e-content, transcript of these tutorials or other learning materials can be put under e-content, and e-assessment and evaluation can be put on under e-assessment. So this is the way we must have to design your course at the Google Classroom page. Okay, so I have designed a Google Classroom page, and I have assigned criteria like this. So e-discussion part will carry the discussion related thing, e-tutorial part will carry the tutorial part, means video tutorial, e-content will be transcript, and e-assessment will carry the assessment part. Okay. Now, I'll be covering the assessment part, okay? I'm not going to tell you how to put under the e-discussion, content under the e-tutorial, which already have been discussed in this FDPs. I'm covering the e-assessment part through rubric features. So how we can create a rubric using this Google Classroom page, okay? So let us create an assignment, okay? And because it is an assessment, we will put under assessment. So you need to go to the create and assignment. Before that, I would request some of the participants then please join this course so that you can see that how this rubric is looks like for you. Okay,
Yes, sir.
so
We
I'm
need code
sharing
editing.
this. Yeah, so I request few of the participants that please join this course. This is for a demonstration purpose so that you can submit the rubric based assignment and it can be evaluated. So this is the my course code. I7 small o GZMZ.
I request
Please join.
participants to join this class so
Yeah.
that we can see how it will be visible and how it can be utilized. Sir, we can continue.
Okay, so here no one has joined it. I would request you to join at least few students, a few participants, so that we can demonstrate how this rubric works for you and how it looks like for from a student perspective. Okay. Okay, I'll wait. This is my course code, and I request you to please join at least few participants so that we can demonstrate this feature. Okay, no issue. So I'm going to create a rubric-based assignment. Okay. What I have done that here, go to the create an assignment part. Here assignment will be, you can create assignment just like I'm evaluating a BTech project report. So I could write BTech project report. Okay. Assignment. I can write instruction to a student. Here is students. This is rubric based assignment for your BTP report. Okay. I can set the criteria. Even it can be later. I can set it, there's no problem with it. Okay, but the foremost important that here you have to define the rubric. There's the option of rubric. Okay, so click on the rubric. Okay, there would be three options you have, that is create rubric, reuse rubric, and import from the seed. So either you can create the rubric, or you can reuse the rubric, or you can directly import from a seed. Three, all these three options you will have. Okay, so you can create rubric, or you can. So I'm creating rubric. Okay, just click on create rubric. Okay, now you will have different criteria. Okay, so I said that we require three things. One is the criteria, then level of performance, and then the descriptor. These three things would be needed. Even for criteria, you can write the descriptor, but the foremost important areas is for level of performance. Okay. So here, there would be two options. One is if you are using the scoring method, okay, so use scoring method, or you can directly evaluate based on the criteria selected. Okay, so either just like in this, this is the criteria I have. Either I can put proficient, good, acceptable, and unacceptable as a criteria for non-scoring. And if I have to score, I can put 4 for excellent, 3 for good, 2 for fair, and 0 for poor. Okay, so I'm going to use a scoring method. Okay, if I'll click on that, it will create a non-scoring. Okay, so I'm using the scoring. Okay, first criteria, it will ask to create the criteria. Okay, so so criteria you have to write, just like first criteria I am setting it. So I'm just copy and pasting so that it will save our time. Hypothesis, here I can write the this descriptor, means criteria descriptor. You can write or you can leave it blank. It is optional field, which may or it is optional field. You won't require any descriptor. It is hypothesis is self-explanatory. They can understand that this criteria you use for. Even you can write it write like this. This criteria is used for evaluating your hypothesis. Okay, it will work. Now, this is very important. This is nothing but the level. Okay, level of performance, which is very much important. Here I have, if I'm using the scoring method, I can use the level of performance based on the scoring method. So 4 is the excellent, 4 is the maximum mark. So each criteria would score the 4 marks. Okay, so what I'm going to do that I have copied the excellent, and this is I have assigned the 4 marks. Level title, I have, this is very important. If I am writing the level, I must have to write the descriptor. Okay, so descriptor is, I have written clearly, so I can write. Okay, if I am marking as a descriptor as a 4 marks with excellent, it means that hypotheses are clearly stated with specific direction predictions. Now click on this add a level. So I am adding so many levels you can add based on the Likert scale. I am adding the different level. Okay, so now I have 3 marks for good. So I can assign 3. And the criteria is good, and the descriptor I have. This is the descriptor. Okay, if I'm marking as a good, it means that hypotheses are stated with a specific direction prediction, but it is not clear. Then again, click on plus. Again, go to 2 for fair. I have assigned 2 marks, and it is the fair grade. And again, I have written the descriptor. Okay, so if I'm marking as a fair, it means that it makes some prediction, but it is non-directional and unclear. And the next is the poor grade for 0. So I have made I'm giving 0 marks with poor level of performance, and here again I'm writing descriptor is very important. Okay. So one part is over. Now I have assigned 4 is the maximum mark, so you will see that the first criteria maximum 4 mark is assigned here. Okay, so first criteria, even you can set many criterias, even you can set 5, 6, and each and every level of level of criteria you can assign the different marks, so there is no restriction about it. So one is over. Now if you have set the criteria as well as the level of performance and descriptor, now go to the add criteria again. So now I'll go to adding the second criteria. So now I have second criteria as method. So I have written method. This is optional field. You could write, or you this criteria you use for evaluating method, you can write. I can evaluate either with the same parameter or different mass I can assign, just like in the same assignment can be evaluated. Just like I'm giving hypothesis for 4 marks and for methods is very important, so I'm assigning 5 marks for method. So it is totally depends on you. So you can set even different level of parameters for different set of criteria, so there is no restriction at all. Okay, here I'm putting the excellent. Either I can give more marks also. Okay, so I'm putting the excellent. Let's see, I'm assigning 7 marks for excellent here. Here I was giving only 5 marks. See the beauty of this one. Okay, if I'm assigning 7 marks, you will see that it added 4 plus 7. And I could write the description here. Then I have to go, just like I have assigned 5 marks for good. And descriptor, I have written this descriptor. Done. Then again, I have assigned, suppose that 3 marks for fair and 3 marks okay. Even if I put, suppose that someone has performed worst, then I can assign 1 marks and label title I can give it's poor. But even he performed poor, at least he has written something, or she has written something, so I can assign 1 marks. Okay. So this criteria is over now. So just click on add a new criteria. You could see my 2 criteria is I got 17 marks. Now let us create a new criteria. The third criteria I am creating, the result section, which is very important. Okay. Result section is okay. I can write the description, or it is optional. Here, result section is very important. So I can assign, suppose that 9 marks for excellent. Okay, then 7 marks I can assign for good, and here I can write even 5 marks I have assigned for fair. And description I could write and again I'm giving 2 marks at least for poor, and description you can assign 0 marks as well. It based on your marking scheme. So three criteria I have selected so far. Out of it is 20 marks assignment. Okay. So similarly, you can add more criteria. You can complete this assignment as well. I am adding only three criteria to save the time. Okay. Now, what we need to do here, once you complete the rubric assignment based on the scoring method, just check once, is it correct in all aspect? Yeah, because once you save that, you could not make any changes. So before, make sure that it is correct in all aspect. Okay. So yeah, it is done. I have checked so far. Now save it. Okay. Once you save it, you see now it will come rubric three criteria or 20 marks. Now I have assigning 20 marks here. And due date I have given, suppose that till tomorrow. Time I can assign till 11:15. And topic I have listed e-assessment. Okay, the work is over. So so you know it will go to you. Now I have assigned. So student, the participant who have joined this course, they must see. Okay, now I got so many people, so I'm requesting participant to upload to see this rubric assignment and upload. There is, you will see this assignment and upload the assignment there. Upload the assignment. Okay, just like if you have any research paper or any material, I will evaluate based on that parameter only. But you can upload any dump file or any file. So I'll delete after this, talk. So that we can demonstrate how it is going to work. So there would be option that is add file and then sub turned in. So go to the add file, select any file you can select, and then there is an option is turned in. Click on turned in, it will appear here. And you will see this is for you only to see how these rubrics work. So I would request participant to submit at least few assignments so that we can see the evaluation part. So a few of them have uploaded, so I'm going to check it. Okay, just like cyber security notes by this is the by evaluating. Once you for evaluating, just click on that link. You will see that how many people have submitted and how many students have not submitted it. So go to by clicking on that assignment, you directly you will jump to this platform. Okay, so this is the file by Sangama madam, and she has uploaded an assignment. Okay, so now you will see that my rubric-based assignment will look like this. Okay, see here at the top you will see the assignment part. Here in this panel you can see the entire assignment. Here you can see the grading system, but you won't have to do anything here. Here you will see the rubric. Okay, and based on the parameter, it will create a rubric feature. Okay, so let's see how we can evaluate. Suppose that this assignment is you simply you have to go to the this one. There is check option grading. Click on that grading system, and then in hypothesis, suppose I have seen the assignment in hypothesis section. I found that it is good. So just click on good. It will show also the each and every tabs show the different level of performance. In methods, I got a very excellent methods in this assignment. I click on this one. Even in result section, I found that it is good. So now the grade is automatically calculated here, and you can write your comment also. Good effort. Okay. And return. Once you click on return, it will return to concerned students. So this is way we can grade. And you see that if I can add more students, suppose that if I can add more teachers in that, the same assignment can be evaluated by so many teachers. Okay. Even I can take the method part, others can take the hypothesis part, and some other faculty may take result and discussion part. So this is the way the same assignment can be evaluated by so many teachers, and they can give the grade for only that part, not for all the part. Okay, so this is the beauty of rubric based assignment, and consistently we can grade this student and they can see their level of performance as well. Okay, here I have already evaluated one student, so you could see here you can see her grade also, that by clicking I have evaluated. In hypothesis I have given 3 out of 4, in methods I have given 7 out of 7, and in result I have given 7 out of 9. So this, see, it is clearly reflected evaluation method. And by this, if you have created a rubric, you can reuse for multiple time without any worrying about transparencies. Or just like in same assignment, if you are evaluating the question number one, you can create the rubric for each and every question. Even you can make the parameters in each and every questions. So you can evaluate on the certain parameters, and a student will see that, a student can see that if what the hypothesis means. Okay, here by clicking she can see her level of performance. You see, she can see that she got good grade. It means that hypothesis are, so you are writing comment as well for, so this will bring you transparency as well as confidence. Hypothesis are stated with a specific direction prediction, but it is not clear very much. So a student can find the lacuna, they can also improve further. In excellent, you could see that all information measured or variable are predicted and explained, and result section, it is most criteria as made, but there may be some lack of clarity and incorrect information. So you see how students are clearly, they can see the level of performance, which is not possible for simple evaluation method. That's why I would personally recommend everyone that use rubric. It's one of the very good and very a promising solution for assessment method. And the student will see their level of performance based on the descriptor you have adopted. So use it, and it is just very simple. Again, I'm going to repeat, it is very simple for you. It's very simple, and you can see that, just like you can could see there are so many people have submitted, just like Poonam ma'am has submitted the BTP the same way we can grade. So it's the same process you have. You have to click on this one, okay, so that you can start grading it. By default it is automatically selected, and you could see here also the return, whether it is return or not. Okay, so just like I have graded 7 for method, hypothesis for 3, and result for 2. So, and here I can write any specific comment and I can return. Okay, and now she got 16 out of 20, and it will be automatically comes here. So, you know, this is the beauty of this. The Classroom, Google Classroom, that it is inbuilt, it is integrated directly here, and you could see the student who are evaluated and their level of performance. Okay, so this is the way it will work. Right, keep trying creation of rubric. There is a lot of rubrics available, and here you could see the her, by clicking on her profile, you can directly see then which part she is lacking, and click on that link. You see, it means that she has done excellent on hypothesis and method section, but result section she did not perform well. So she can, and even teachers can easily see the level of performance of a student based on the criteria. So this is the beauty of rubric, and there is a lot of rubrics are available over the web. You can Google it, you can use it for different purpose, even you can create your own rubric for different kind of assignment. So I hope that this is beneficial for you, and I hope that you understand about rubric feature. If you have any question regarding rubric, you can ask me so that we can go further for Google assignment part. Okay, so if you have any question regarding rubric, you can ask me now.
Yes, sir. So let's wait for the questions. If you have any pending questions, though things have been explained in a very systematic, step by step by way. So let's wait for questions possibly. Yeah. So let's continue, sir, because we are not getting any specific question.
Okay.
Right,
okay.
Now.
So you try to develop rubrics, and you know it's a very good features available through many of the learning management system, including Moodle. So you can create rubric and use it for different type of assignment. Okay, so now there is a new feature with the Google. It's a new product of Google, and people who are not using directly Classroom may use this feature. Even it is very easily integrated with many of the learning management system like Moodle and many other platforms. It is very easy to use, so I'm going to demonstrate a new feature of product of Google, which is not yet a part of this assignment, but it has certain new features. This is nothing but a Google assignment. Google assignment is a new product of Google. Go to the assignments.google.com, and it is a G Suite application, so you must have to use your institutional ID and password. Okay. Institutional ID and password, which is registered with the Google Suite account. You have to use it because it is not yet available for normal Gmail account. Okay.
Sir, before we going to discuss new part, okay. There is a question from participant Megha Dishman. How to retrieve marks details of all students from the Google
it is very easy now. Go to the grades. There is the option of grading here. Okay, so once you give so many assignments, so many marks here, there is an option here. Click on that. Go to the grades. Click on that. Okay, just wait. Even there is an option of grading. Here there is an option that you directly calculate from there. Here is the grade. Here you will see, by clicking on that assignment, you will see the copy all grade to Google Sheet, download all grade to CSV. So once you can download into CSV, or only these grade can be evaluated on all grade. So if you put all the assignment, all the grading here, here you can copy in Google Sheet or you can download it. Once you download it, you will find that it is student details as well as their detailed marking. So it's very easy to do with the Google Classroom. Here you will see that you will find the all student here, detail as well as their grade. Okay, you see, these three students have been evaluated and they got only two students. This is 20 marks, and Poonam Sharma, she got 16, and Sangama Madam, she got 17. Okay, so you can download from there. So it's very easy to use. Okay, just follow that step. Go to the grades, assignment, and then click on this button. Okay. This feature is it is very much good for descriptive type of questions. Even Google Classroom, Google Forms is very useful for objective type of question. You can shuffle the question and you can change the nature of question as well. But many of the learning management system like Moodle, it offers more features than Google offers. But this is a rubric based thing with the Google Classroom is a very interesting part, and it is very easy to use as well. Okay, sir.
Yeah, I think we can go ahead. Okay. Yeah, so there is a question, sir. Just wait a second. So question is like from Arumiren Benival, sir. How to make different folders for different assignments? We can easily got specified.
Yes, it is very easy. I got her thing. It's very easy that each and every type of assignment have different folders. Here you will see open folder for assignment. Okay, so just click on that, you will see all the assignment is there in Google Drive. Got it? Just click on this link. There is a link here.
Yeah, so I think we can go ahead and now.
Yeah. So just click on the particular assignment folder. It will go to directly, and once you download the whole course, it will come folder wise assignment too, even the content part. That's why I have recommended that your structure would be in that part, that e-assessment, e-content, e-discussion, e-tutorial, e-content, and e-assessment. So create a structure like that. It would be suitable for you while taking the backup and involving a student in teaching learning process. Is it okay? So shall I proceed, sir?
Yes, sir, we can go ahead.
Now I'm going to demonstrate a new feature that is known as the assignment, okay? Sir, can I take a 2 minutes break?
Yes, sir, sure, sir.
Just 2 minutes.
I hope you are well.
Yeah, I'm well.
yes, we can take that. So let me share some
instructions. 2 minutes,
sure, sir. So actually, what we are doing, we will be posting FDP feedback form, our feedback link to the feedback form in the, or maybe during the second session itself. And basically, we have FDP feedback or FDP interaction. Scheduled or planned just after the second session, right? So once we will be completing the second session, evening session, there will be around a 25 to 30 minute session for interaction. So I expect each and every to be there, because it will be helping us to understand that how much we have disseminated, actually how much content or how much learnings we have shared with the participants. So that's one part. And Once we will be completing that interaction part, I will be posting, I will be uploading the participation certificate in the Google Drive folder, right? So I will be uploading all the basically eligible participants means for the FDP or FDP. So I will be posting the certification certificates into that folder only. And after that, if you found something not correct, so I'm taking care of possible mistakes in the certificate. If you found something is not correctly written, like institute name or your name actually, so kindly let me through a mail actually, right? So I will be responding you as soon as possible for, right? So yes, sir, please.
Yeah. So this is the new product and new features of Google, which is known as Google Assignment. So go to the assignments.google.com. And you log in through your G Suite application. You must have to log in through your institutional ID and password. Okay, and you can create it with very good features by the teachers who even only use this platform to create assignments. So they won't have to use Google Classroom or any learning base. Simply, they can create the assignment here. Even rubric-based assignment, they can be created. And any kind of, and even the best part of this feature is that you can see the similarity index, that you can check the plagiarism of students as well. So this is the very good feature, and soon I think that they are going to adopt with integrate this feature with the Google Classroom as well. Okay, so for G Suite application, so it's very good tool. That go to assignments.google.com, you will see the assignment page like this. Okay, this would be a page. Once you log in, your assignment would be appear here. Here you will have plenty of options. Here I'm only creating the assignment for the students. Okay, I'll create the assignment and share the links through the WhatsApp, through social platform, or any other. So the student can log in through their Gmail account and they can submit the assignment. So a student won't have to register with your course directly through Google Classroom, but they can submit the assignment from anywhere. Even in India, there is a problem of infrastructure, and many students who are in remote area, they could not access Google Classroom frequently because due to net connectivity and a lot of other problems. Okay, so they can use this feature to directly submit the assignment. Even the facilities it has, that you can see the student similarity index, that you can check the plagiarism as well, which is not possible through Google Classroom creation assignment option. Okay, so go to the assignment.google.com, and there's an option to create. Here it is the required section you have, that is, you can create new course here. So here there would be option, I'm going to explain. Yeah, at the top you need to create the course. Okay, and that you need to define the title, instructions, the title of the assignment, instructions for a student, total grading point, due date, and file CFUR. Just like you have created an assignment in a file, so you can upload that assignment and it will work for you. Okay, and even there is a rubric based assignment, you can use it. Okay, so let us do one by one. Okay, so I'm creating a new course here, like NIT FDP, NIT KKR, same course I'm adopting, OTL. Section, I don't have any section, so just create a course. Okay, course is created. All course would be listed here. I have created many other course, so it is listed here. So here you can search by course wise. Here I can write the same thing I'm using. Okay, BTP. You can create rubric based assignment or simple assignment. I can write this is your BTP assignment. Okay. Here, point you can assign, suppose that it is 20 marks. Due date I have to assign. I have assigned 28. Okay. And time I can assign. Here I can attach any of the assignments. Suppose that you have given assignment in a Word or Excel or PowerPoint file. You can attach any file, and you can either there is an option that this is the very normal option that you can do that. Even you can create the rubric based assignment. Okay, so I can reuse rubric based assignment. Okay, if I'm having, let's see, it will search. I don't have any rubric based assignment till date. If it is already there, I could show it. Okay, there is other option, that is I can import from a Google Sheet. Let's see, I'm going to export and I'm going to import that assignment. Okay, there's nothing here, but I can import directly from file. Let us export the rubrics here. Here there is an option, export to the sheet. I'm going to use save rubric. Okay. Okay, it is done. It is shareable also. Either I can download it and import it. Let's see. Yeah. I can download it. Any format I can download it. Even CSV format I can take, TSV format I can take. Let's download in XLS format. Okay, I'm going to use it here. This is already done. Okay, here I'm going to upload. I've already created a rubric. What is? Only Google Sheet are supported. It is not supported XLR format. Only Google Sheet will be supported. So we must have to export through Google Sheet only. So it is not supporting as well till now, but they are going to improve further. Let's see if we can have a Google Sheet. Let's see if it will work. If it will not work, you can create also. This feature is not it. They have, because it's a new feature, they have not it. Seat. Okay. Let's see if it is added. No, it can't be added. Otherwise, you can create manually. There is no problem with that. Okay. I'm checking that it will work for CSV or not. It's not working as well. There is a one thing you can do here that I'm going to use Google Sheet and this is my institutional ID and I'm going to import. Let's see whether it will work or not. Okay. I have imported already. Okay, so let's see it working or not. Reuse rubric. There is no rubric, it's so that it's not found. So we will go for another option, that is rubric already, you know. So save as Google Sheet. I'm saving in Google Sheet so that I can use it. This format dependently, I wanted to use it so that I can see that okay, so here let's see now it will work or not. Reuse rubric is not showing at all. If something has been created, it must be shown here, otherwise we could not use this rubric feature. This is the assignment I have. Okay, leave it. It's not working in other format, so it's better idea to create rubric. There is a good option here that you can reuse or you can import from the Google Sheet if it is there. Currently, it is only supporting the Google Sheet. So this is. I think this is the new format we have. Yeah, because I have saved in Google Sheet, now it's working. You see, save in Google Sheet and I have saved. So save assignment, what I have done that I have used that rubric. Okay, I have saved in Google Sheet because it was not taking in Google Sheet. Now the same assignment, because it was a different account, G Suite account of my university. So here there is an option of check plagiarism. It is very good here option. Okay, so five assignment which only the five till now, because it is in experimental, it is in beta version, that's why they have not announced it. So what up to five assignment it can check for similarity index. Okay, so now you got this one and I am publishing. Okay, I can add a student from here directly. Okay, there is an option. I am publishing now. Let us see first. Okay, so this is assignment I have. Okay, and here I can see the report. This is the link which can be shared directly to the students, just like I'm sharing this link to the that classroom page. So I'm copying link, and this is our course page, and I am sharing the link here. Okay, now I would request participant, at least you submit your assignment by clicking this link. So once you will click the link, all your file would be here, okay, through this assignment. So I have created an assignment, rubric based assignment, which I already have created a rubric for you, and I have used that in 20 marks, okay, and I have shared that link. You can share this link directly through the WhatsApp, through any of the social media platform or any other group. Okay, so a student can directly they can submit the assignment, and I can see the original report of up to five student here. So this is the good feature available with the rubric. So I would request you to please submit some of the submit your assignment by directly clicking this link.
Yes, so we are waiting. Yes, so request participant to kindly upload or respond to the submission assignment.
This follows a completely a different approach of Classroom, that you can share the link directly through any of the platforms where a student can log in and they can submit the assignment directly. Okay, that option is there. Even there is a option of manage people. Once the student will see, you could see the number of people who have submitted the assignment. You can here. You see, I can delete their things also. Even I can add more instructors. Okay. Now I can, you see here, I can see that I can see the assignments submitted by so many participants. Okay, let's take, I can see the originality report up to five student. Okay, so this is the Vikram sir assignment, and I can evaluate, as well as I can see the details also, that is originality report. Okay, so let me evaluate. I am evaluating. Okay, so I can return his grade. Okay, I have not returned it, but it is saved. Even he has submitted multiple file, I can return multiple submission as well. So let me go once to show one feature. Here there is an originality report, okay? Others got a very good, here only you could see that original report, okay? Here in this assignment, which is submitted by Pankaj Sarkar sir, here I can see the originality, okay? Okay. You see, this question is, you know, web matches. It is matched. You see, it is matched from this this website. Okay, from this website. So it create a similarity index for you. Okay, you could see here. Out of his assignment, he can see that the two questions, one from web matches and one for direct from website. So it show, although the originality report, if you see, the 5% contents are, you know, are copied or taken references from there, and 10% from cited or quoted content. Okay, so this, it will show the similarity report. So here, I could not see, you know, except this assignment, I could not see others, you know, others got the 100% in originality. Only the Pankaj Sarkar assignment have a little plagiarism, that is similarity index. Okay, and it has one way to, you know, to see the details, and it is very much different from Turnitin or Urkund software similarity index. So it only it counts the where it matches, and it gives results in terms of the web sources consulted or any other things consulted. So this question has been copied, so it shows from web matches, and only this question is copied, so it shows from web matches. So whenever you because it was a unique assignment submitted by the participant. Okay, sorry. Unique assignment submitted by the participant, so it was not showing the similarity index. However, however, if a student will submit their assignment, there will be huge chances, there will be huge possibilities that they will get the large number of similarity index. Okay, so it is. Okay, so this is a very good feature available with the Google Classroom, and you know, it is a separate Google platform, which is Google Assignment, where you can create the assignment based on various features available, either the rubric based assignment or any other kind of assignment. The best part of that that it takes some time, you know, just like this Prasad M sir, he got 31 passages. So he got more similarity, you know, plagiarisms. Even not, I'm not saying plagiarism, copied content rather than anyone. So it takes some time to evaluate, where any of the plagiarism software takes some time to evaluate the content. So only the best part of this feature is that what you can do, that you can see the originality report, and originality report is very much good criteria to judge or evaluate any students. So here you can evaluate the student based on the originality report, just like this assignment has a lot of content copied from so many sources. So you could see here the things, and based on this you know, content, you could evaluate someone assignment. Okay, so this is a very good feature, and it takes some time to evaluate. You see, it highlights the content. okay. It is if you percentage wise, you see all things are highlighted. 89%, this 89%, it matches with the wave. Okay, so if you originality report is concerned, you will see that large number of content is matched with the internet sources. So you could see it is highlighted in different color, and you can even you can download the report and you can take your decision about evaluations. Okay, even there is a possibility here that you can print this originality report so that you can show to the students that this much originality report you got. And there are a lot of things you see here. You will save it. I have saved. You see, it will show that course name, student name, file name, report created on this date. So it will show the flash passages 89%, and from quoted passages it take cited 15.8%, and it will show that it is copied, it is taken from this source 86.96%. And it will show all these copies content. Okay, this is from a student passage, this is from top match, it will highlight and it will give the references too. You see, so a student now they cannot cheat to the faculties, to the teachers, and they can evaluate these assignment based on the originality report feature, which is not there in Google Classroom assignment feature. So you know, things are coming out and it is the new feature. Although it is very simple to use, it you won't have to do anything. Simply you have to go to click on that link, create a course, even you can add more participants here and share that link directly to any other social media platform so that a student can be evaluated. Although this is in developing state, although it is you know, is not yet fully functional, a lot of features need to be improved, and it is coming out in future. It is certainly it is going to be a very good tool for evaluation and assessment. So this is a brief about the rubric based assignment. Even any kind of assignment you can evaluate through the Google Classroom assignment feature, as well as the Google assignment tool available through Google assignment. So this is the brief I have so far I have covered so far regarding these two assessment tools. If you have any questions or any suggestion, please let me know.
Yeah, so sir, actually we have got one or two questions, or maybe.
Okay.
So, like Rashmi ma'am asking, is it useful only in the case checking assignment, or can we use it before submitting research publication?
So yeah, you can do for research publication as well if you want. It you know, it never asks that the assignment, it never check that this is assignment. It check assignment in any kind of material. Okay, so whether you are checking your research paper, it is a good idea, but up to for till date up to 5 assignment it can be checked through originality report, and future it is possible that they will integrate with the more features. And even this Swayam platform and many others, Moodle platform, this learning management platform, they have an option that it can be integrated with any of the plagiarism detection software like Urkund or iAuthenticate or Turn18. But India, I have not seen any institution they have adopted. Even I have personally, I was talking with the person who is managing this Swayam platform. So I had suggested long back fact that it is always better idea that to integrate this model with the Turnitin or iAuthenticate, so that whenever participants or candidates are submitting their assignment, teachers can see the similarity index, and say on the basis of similarity index itself, teachers can reject or accept the submission. So it is the one check option that is with the first stage. Based on similarity index, you can reject or accept the assignment. When I was a Commonwealth Fellow at University of London, and you know, they had this option with their learning management system Moodle, and it was quite good, and I found it very interesting that they have integrated, and same thing these Google peoples are doing. They have integrated with this assignment option, and it is very good tool that on the first stage we can see that whether this assignment is genuine or this assignment is based on the copied content. So before going to evaluate the assignment, we can set out the first stage, first criteria to evaluate any assignment. So it is a very wonderful tool. Even you can check any kind of resources, there is no problem till now. But I'm sure that in future they are going to improve this this product, and it would add more features. Even up to 5 assignment it can be evaluated, but in future it can be added more, and I'm sure that they will add.
Yeah, so there is another question, like will this originality feature works for image of handwritten work, like submitted?
No, ma'am. Till date, even this Turnitin and this Urkund software, no software is foolproof that it can be determined the plagiarism of an image. Okay, so it is not possible till date, and even I'm using this Turnitin and Urkund as well. I've seen it won't detect images. That's why in StudyTalk we have been discussing that while using the image for writing research paper or writing thesis or submitting the assignment, make sure that it is OER images. Okay. So use OER images, and it is the foolproof mechanism you have, and many people are adopting this. Even when you are submitting your research paper, now publisher, they started asking that instead of asking that whether you took permission from the using these images, now they are asking that whether these images are available under OER or Creative Commons. So they will ask that under which Creative Commons license it is available. So now the things are changing, and it is always a better idea to use open educational resource image rather than using copyrighted image.
Right. So similar to that. So is it possible you to read the comment, because it is related to the context we have discussed? Yeah. So Sangma, I'm asking, yeah, like even we want to our option where we can check when a student copy each other assignment.
Yeah, that's you could each other assignment would be it is the reliable judgment by the teacher side, but it can be seen that how much content or which portion of the assignment is copied. So if you go through one by one assignment, you could see that the portion, okay, the phases student copied. And it is the human effort, it is the intellectual effort, it can be done at the teacher side as well. Even it is through Turnitin also, it is not possible that from each other how many content is copied. Unless it is all content should be hosted at open repository.
Yes. So yeah, similar to that, there is a question by Poonam ma'am is asking question like, can we use this for checking plagiarism in the answer sheet where student copying answers from each other? So it's like can we check is a local plagiarism?
It's a local plagiarism, because you could not, it's an intellectual process, and you have to decide whether they have copied from each other or not. Because it is not possible, because it's local checking, no. So you know, it will check all the assignment. It will display the portion they have copied from the web resources or any other resources available over the web.
Right.
Even it is not possible to print it.
Yes.
But yes, handwritten, the people are working. Even C-REC is working for plagiarism detection. It's the similar like for Indian languages, Indian and Dravidian languages. So, you know, maybe it would be possible in future that the handwritten material can be OCR'd and then it can be converted into human readable format, machine readable format, and then it can be checked with the plagiarism software. That may be possible in the future. And even C-REC is working regarding this, because they got an assignment to check the Indian language plagiarism, and it is now functional, and they are working for the Dravidian language too.
Yeah, so I think we have done with questions, sir. Though we are little, we are closing little early, so we can do that, because most of the things has been covered in this session related to the bricks-based assignment.
So I have not covered this Google Classroom in detail. No, this is a very common and nowadays people are here. I have covered so for the rubric-based evaluation as well as the assignment-based evaluation
In Google Classroom, sir. One thing I wanted to understand: whenever we have we plan a MCQ based. So I am for BTech students. I used to conduct examination in Google form. So there is one section for MCQ based question,
exactly.
And there is a second section in the same quiz which is having this text based, means descriptive questions. So I used to evaluate manually, naturally, for the second section. So what is the way, I mean, what is the best or efficient way to evaluate these responses submitted by students, descriptive? I mean,
best way is it is always better, you know. Even Google Forms, you can ask a student to submit their file as well. Okay. So for descriptive question, they could, even if they are not very comfortable in writing online, they can write handwritten, and they can upload their file there. So in the Google form itself, you ask that you submit, you attach a file. So in PDF format or in image format, any kind of format is possible. It is always recommended idea to create a PDF file for each and every question and upload there. Okay. So once they will attach those things, so there is an option in Google Form itself. The question you are putting in auto grading, or you are you will do the manual grading. Mm-hmm. For the question like MCQs and short question type, you can put even the auto grading. But descriptive type of question, because they will submit and it will go in a folder. So because ultimately, if you click manual grading option, you will see, and you can directly click there, you can directly click from their files, and you can evaluate, you can assign the marks, because it's a manual grading. No, in attachment file you put as manual grading, okay, so that you can click it, and once you click it, you can see their files and you can give marks directly. So it would be the online assessment only, but you are assigning a manual grading system for that question,
right,
which is handwritten, and they have uploaded through file method. So that is the best method possible through Google Forms.
Yes. So I think we have done these questions. Still, we are waiting for the questions. If participant is having any question,
If you have any question, any queries, you can ask me.
Yeah. So there is a question, sir. Now, can we use rubric criteria for a particular question in a question paper?
Exactly. That I said in the beginning, that for a particular question, you can define the rubric criteria. Criteria would be your, it should be self-explanatory, as well as whatever the criteria you are selecting, you must define the level as well as the descriptor. So you can set the criteria for a particular question as well. Even you can say for in a particular question, you can bifurcate the marks also. Suppose that introduction carries 7 marks, Result section carries 10 marks, conclusion section carries 5 marks. By then, you can bifurcate the marks within the question 2. So it is very much possible. It based on your understanding about rubric and how on which parameter you are going to evaluate a student.
Yeah. So actually, we have got some time. So if any participant is having any question,
any question, yeah, you can ask me.
So now we got this whole scenario. So one of the participant, Rashmiam, has posted a
in
scenario.
In many foreign universities, they are learning. Learning management system which automatically evaluate and student assignment, which reduce a lot of work. Yeah, I work a lot of time. Do you think that it would be useful in present education system? Yes, exactly. That I was saying that when I have been with the University of London, and I have seen that I was working with the virtual learning environments and with the Moodle system. What happened, they had already integrated features with their Moodle system. They have integrated Turnitin with the Moodle. And once a student will submit, like this Google assignment feature, it is the similar fashion, it gives the similarity index. And with the color, that is, the red color, yellow color, and red color, yellow color, and green color. And based on this, a student can be directly evaluated, and directly they can their assignment can be accept or reject. So it's a first filtration. But I have seen that these professors, they further, if it is a green or yellow, they further go to that assignment, and they need to be rechecked so that they can have a transparent evaluation of a student. In Indian scenario, yeah, it is very much possible. It is very much possible if a student will be familiar. Nowadays, everyone has a smartphone, internet connectivity, and the techno-savvy ex-students, as well as the modern infrastructure-based institution like IITs, NITs, they could adopt this feature, because most of the students they have are from engineering and techno-savvy friendly students. So they can submit the assignment directly in digital format, and it can be evaluated through Turnitin or iAuthenticate, and based on that mechanism, it can be given grade. Even automatically, grade can be assigned based on the similarity index if you made the criteria. Based on the similarity, you can create the criteria. If similarity index would be more than 10, so this much mark will be assigned. If it is less than 10, then this much mark. So you can set the criteria in learning management system. In India, it is very much possible, but for all institution, it is not possible. But because basically the state universities and many other universities where infrastructure is very poor, their students are not very techno friendly, and they could not even they don't have laptops to create their assignment in digital format. So that is the biggest challenge we have.
Yeah. So now
we have lots of registration nowadays, and people, slowly we are migrating towards the online platform. And I have discussed study that so many universities, they have started, online degrees programs in online mode. Even this SWAYAM platform, it got a huge number of registration, as well as many students are appearing. All these RPIT as well as refresher course, they are conducting online, and it is a huge benefit for academic scenario. So slowly it is a slow process, but India is India is the leading institution, and they are contributing 55%. It has 55% growth in e-learning pedagogical adoption. So you could not say that it will take more time. It will take few years, but definitely it is going to be helpful in Indian scenario as well.
Yeah, so
motivation is, you know, if students are very you know, techno savvy, and even students don't write, you know, they prefer to write on digital format, they prefer to write on laptop. Even if you could say that you write a few pages, I would more prefer to write on my laptop through word processing software rather than writing manually. So it is not encouragement, it's sort of, you know, just like what we are doing. We are conducting this workshop, this FTPs online. Earlier, we were not thinking about it. So I have conducted so many workshops by visiting those institutions. So now, necessity, if there would be necessity, definitely it will come out. And students are doing that. You know, in my university, in my department also, our students are from very remote area of Bihar and Odisha. And our university have conducted all examination through online book examination, OBEMO. And successfully we have done. They have written their answer script and uploaded to the portal, and it is done. So we have developed a software. We requested TCS to develop this software for us. And all examination were conducted in, all final year examination were conducted in online OBE mode. So no one can deny it, no. Even we got 100% presence of students. And it is very much possible.
Yes. So I think,
we must have to organize the workshop. We must have to make them aware, just like how to create assignment, how to create this Google-based, rubric-based, so that they should be aware that how these tools and techniques may be helpful for their research and evaluation.
In fact, sir, in the last week, actually last week, maybe in this week itself, we have got a kind of notification from MNNIT Jaipur that they're conducting a workshop to train the students, actually, how to involve in assignment, how to well-behaving is one part, naturally.
Exactly.
Yeah, so how to be in the online class, how to submit the assignment, how to appear for the examination. So now these things are also started happening.
We must have to develop in India. We don't have e-learning policies. And recently I got a project in this direction that I'm developing a strategic model for India in terms of e-learning pedagogical framework. So it will take some time because we have new education policies. Our policy must be framed in the line of new education policies to achieve the motive of new educational policies. So it will take time, but definitely we are going to achieve very soon.
Right. So yeah. So I think we can conclude now.
Yeah.
And we'll connect for the second session. So second session will be like, it will be more or less on model-based assessment, how to prepare a proper configurations for the different type of assessment on a model-based platform. So I hope a participant will be there by 2:30 because we need to start early so that we can close early, and we will be doing the remaining parts of the FDP after that. So thank you, sir. Let's be connected by 2:30. Right, sir. Thank you.